Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Sarah Wisted. Today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my modern minimal. And obviously you guys know I like to keep it super minimal, so there's not a lot going on, but I did pick up a few things to make it feel a little bit more holiday-ish. We do have a newborn baby. She's actually 7 months old, so we're trying to step up our holiday decor just a bit. So I'll be showing you guys kind of in like the main areas of our house. It's a little bit more minimal. And then I am trying my best to include some like traditional holiday decor over in the like den area is what we're calling it. So in the entryway, we just picked up a few little things from, I actually just went to Target and picked up a few things, and I had a few things from Crate and Barrel left over. I started out with just getting this cute little letters from Santa, I guess, tin box. I just thought it would be kind of fun, like when Shay gets a little bit older, that we could actually write a letter to Santa and put it in this little box. So I was trying to think like longer term, like some nostalgic things that maybe we could do with her. I never did that when I was little, so I don't know if you guys did that when you were little, but I just thought that'd be kind of like a fun thing to do. So the next items that I have over here, let me move you guys closer, hold on a second. The next items that I included in our entry decor are these cute little like iron reindeers. I've had these for a few years now and they are still like one of my favorites. I just think they're like cute with like the extra long legs, and they're just iron, so they're pretty minimal and they go pretty much with anything. So I just have a set of two of these. I think these are from Crate and Barrel, and I think Crate and Barrel brings them back every year, so I'll try and link those below for you as well. And then something that I really like to do with my holiday decor is just throw like random ornaments just like out, because I feel like ornaments can be so beautiful. So instead of just having them on a tree, I like to like throw them out just kind of like sporadically on the table or like in a bowl or something like that, because I just think, I don't know, ornaments are so beautiful. And I picked these ones up at Target because they are, I just like really love the pointiness, I guess. So yeah, that's where I got these, and I just placed them out here just because I feel like it makes it a little less, like when things are like too symmetrical, I feel like it doesn't look as good. So I'm trying to make it feel like a little bit lived in just by throwing some ornaments around. These next two guys I just picked up also from Target, and they're these super skinny, super minimal, like sparse, they're called Alpine trees, and they're pre-lit, so you can plug them in. We've actually had these lit for, I wanna say like a week or two now. I hope that they last a long time. My husband seems to think that the LED light bulbs last a really long time. So we've just kept them lit this entire season, which is actually really nice, because when you walk through like the hallways, we have our different like trees just throughout the house, and it just, something about like lights at night, like sparkling, just make it feel more holiday-esque for us. So I did pick up two of these just to kind of like offset the balances. I was gonna do three, but now that I have these laid out on my table, I actually love the two here. But I do know if you have like a bigger entryway and you wanted to do a third one, I think that could look really cool as well. But I essentially picked these up because I wanted to add some height in this area, and what better way to add height than some greenery, so some trees. Formal living space. I only call it formal because it's like we're all like the white status, so we keep it a little bit more tidy in here. But like I mentioned, we did want to do like an aesthetic Christmas space and then also like a traditional Christmas space, which is like back in that room that I'll show you guys in a bit. So this space, we pretty much kept it minimal, lots of white, greenery, lights, like that kind of thing. So I started out by, I guess the first thing that I like put up was all the greenery that you see around. If you saw my video last year, I actually found this cedar pine like faux garland off of this website called Craft Outlet. Just randomly stumbled upon it because I was on the hunt for some really beautiful greenery that I could have every year. As much as I would love to do real greenery every year, it is a little bit of a pain and it's also super expensive. So I found a really affordable option to get a really beautiful, like wispy, minimal vibe, but you could use it every year. And I'll link those down below, but I do believe they're sold out, so I'm sorry. You have to buy them like so early. If you follow me on Instagram, I do try and post when they're available every year. So hopefully I will get to that next year as well so I can share when they're available next year. But the best part about these is they pretty much are the Crate and Barrel dupes. Like they are, in terms of quality, they look very similar to the Crate and Barrel ones, but they are a fraction of the price. Like they're, I think they're less than half of the price per strand. I did buy a bunch of strands. I think I have like 20 strands now, and I'm gonna continue to buy more because I feel like you can just put greenery everywhere. So yeah, I'll leave that link down below, but I just love these. I feel like this is one of the best finds that I've had for my holiday decor. So I cannot say good enough. Is that even how you say it? I can't say enough good things about this garland. So after the garland, after the greenery, I of course wanted to add a little something to my coffee table. I don't love a lot of like knickknacks and trinkets on my coffee tables, but I did add some trees, and I found these trees at Target, and they're like white. They look kind of like whimsical, and I don't know, I just really loved like the look of them, and they also lit up, which I thought was kind of cool. Like I mentioned earlier, I feel like there's nothing that screams holiday more than just like lights like at night. So I just thought that was like kind of a cool addition. So I got two of them to kind of balance it out and style them up on the coffee table. And then of course I get a candle because every year I'm like so big into like smells and the way your house smells. And there's nothing better than a Christmas candle than balsam fir smell just like throughout the house. I don't know about you guys, but it just like really screams Christmas to me, and it just makes it feel a little bit extra cozy. Okay, so now we're over by our formal Christmas tree, and I did keep it super minimal. I almost didn't put any ornaments on it, but I decided last minute I can at least put the clear ornaments on it because I do feel like it adds a little holiday something, but it's not overwhelming. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that I had a major fail in the fact that I tried to do tinsel this year and it just didn't work out for me. I found this really beautiful like inspo pick from Sean Anderson Design. I just felt like this picture just really felt homey, Christmassy. I don't even really know the other right words to say. So knowing me, I tried to recreate it and it was a major fail. I like need to rethink it and try again next year, but I do want to try and accomplish it again next year because I think tinsel is such a classic, like old school, like I guess decor item to use. And I think it'd be really fun to understand how to use it in a Christmas tree. So maybe next year, but this year we're keeping our tree super minimal with just the clear like glass ornaments. I actually got these ones off of Amazon like 3 years ago, I think it was. I wasn't able to find them last year, but I'll try and link a similar option down below. This tree we actually got at Home Depot. I was on a hunt for like a realistic Christmas tree that was, I think this one is 9 feet, yeah. It's 9 feet. If you guys can imagine, trees that look somewhat real and are also super tall can be quite an investment, which one day I do plan to invest in a really nice one, but this year was not that year. So we just picked up this one from Home Depot, and I actually really love the quality of it. From a lot of the other trees that I've seen, this one is a really great option. And again, you guys, I went to a few different stores and like did my research, so I'm really happy with this one. So if you're looking for a affordable, realistic, taller option, this one's a really great option for you. And for the tree skirt down here, I actually just threw around a blanket that we have, and it's just a cable knit, just like blanket that we got from RH a very long time ago. It is a king size blanket, so it's a little bit bigger, which I think is helpful to make it feel more full underneath a bigger Christmas tree. But honestly, you could just use like whatever blankets you have around the house. Like I feel like it just makes it feel more lived in, more cozy. And yeah, that's all I have to say about that. And then quickly, just to show you guys, again, this is garland that I mentioned earlier. We just have this like draped along the fireplace. I threw up some candlesticks, which I feel like most of you probably already have candlesticks, but it's nice to have like a little bit of like balance of height versus no height on the side. And then we just have these like knit aesthetic Christmas stockings because you got to keep it chic on the side of the house. But I don't really know what else to explain about it. It's very neutral, lots of whites, lots of greens, lots of lights. That's kind of like what we were going for. So this is the room that we were trying to make like traditional Christmas, and I realize it's not like super traditional just yet. I feel like to make something traditional, you have to start acquiring like different decor items like over the years. But the main thing that I was super excited about this year was we got stockings with our names on them. So they're like traditional like needlepoint stockings that I just found online, and you can customize it and put your names on them. And these look very, very similar to the stockings that I had growing up. So because we have our new baby girl, I really wanted to have a stocking that she could have throughout her lifetime growing up and throughout Christmas, just like we did. So I found these online. I can't remember the store, but I will link them down below, which I just thought they were kind of cute. They just are very nostalgic and very homey, I guess, if you will. So that's what kind of the theme is for this room. So I did add color in here, and I did them with, I added color through pillows. So I picked up a few red pillows. Again, I really wanted to find some like needlepoint like Christmas pillows, kind of like what we had. I've already begged my mom to let me like basically keep the ones that we had when we were growing up, but they want them for their house, which I totally get. I wouldn't give them away either. So my next year, my goal is to find pillows that are like needlepoint, similar to the stockings, that have like Santa's face on them or like a reindeer or something like that. Because I feel like, I don't know, I just feel like it's kind of cute. You can hear my dog walking down the stairs. Come here, bud. Come here. This is Hobbs. He likes to be in my videos. He likes to snort and make noises and walk down the stairs. Okay. This Christmas tree is a super old Christmas tree that I've had for years. It's just one of those traditional fake faux Christmas trees. And I didn't really have, so you guys know I like to keep everything minimal over here, but I tend to get rid of stuff often. And I'm killing myself because I used to have all these old school like ornaments that were passed down to me from like my family and even Taylor's family. They gave us all these just old ornaments that we used to have on our trees. And I threw them away, and I'm like kicking myself for doing that because they were all mismatched, and I thought I would only want like the pretty Christmas decor. But now I'm like, oh, I wish I had all these mismatched like unique ornaments from like back in the day that I just got rid of. So I'm really bummed about that. But I think I might go to, I feel like you can find like old school ornaments at like thrift stores and stuff like that. Don't quote me on that because I've not seen that. But we donated our ornament, so I assume there's probably ornaments at thrift stores. So maybe I'll go look and see if there's like some old ones that I can pick up from there. For now, we have a very basic silver Christmas tree. All these ornaments are from, I think, Home Goods. So nothing fancy. But one day we hope to build like a full ornament collection. This year we'll probably do one like with Shay's foot, or like whatever the first ornament is that you do with your kids. So hopefully we'll have at least that one. Maybe I'll get some candy canes because we used to put candy canes on our trees every year. Other than that, other red that I tried to bring into the room is I bought some poinsettias. I almost had to forget what that name was called. I got some poinsettias, and I wanted them to feel like, you guys know in Home Alone when he's like has the house and it's all decorated. I feel like there's poinsettias everywhere in that house, and I don't know if it's just me that notices it, but I think it looks so beautiful and it just feels very seasonal. So I wanted to bring some in here. I do like to have poinsettias around during Christmas anyway, just because I feel like it's very like, I don't know. I feel like I keep using the word nostalgic, but maybe that is the right word. So yeah, I got three of them. I just layered them up next to our fireplace. So that, yeah, they just add to the decor. I literally have nothing else to say about them, so there you go. So lastly, I'm really not gonna show you guys anything else because everything else is kind of a mess and not really decorated. But lastly, the thing that I'll say is I do like to have fresh greenery in addition to the faux greenery that I have. I'm probably gonna get some more like pine trees for our kitchen area, but for this video, I wanted to pick up some fresh greenery and show you guys kind of like what I'm talking about. And this greenery that I have on my kitchen table, I just picked up at our local florist. I got like 2 packs of it to make it feel extra full and extra dramatic. But what's really nice about having just fresh florals or fresh greenery is it feels very, these are very in season. So these are like a winter green. So in the summertime, you could switch it out and do like a summer like flower or something big like that. But yeah, it just adds a little touch to make your home feel a little bit more elevated, but also within the season, if that makes sense. Oh, one more thing that I wanted to mention that I love in holiday decor that I think looks really nice that I just haven't really had a chance to find what I like am looking for that. But layering like textures like blankets or like faux fur. I actually have one faux fur here. This is just from IKEA, so this is like not fancy at all, but I'd like to find like a faux fur that looks really, really nice, like a bigger one, and get a white one and drape it over my white couch. I think would look so beautiful. So if you guys have faux fur or are looking for something extra to make your home feel cozy, but just during the holiday season, I feel like faux fur is a great option for that. And then also like really comfortable blankets, and like, I'm gonna go get this one blanket that I got from Crate and Barrel and show you, or not Crate and Barrel, where did I get it from? CB2. Let me go grab that and I'll talk about it in a second. Okay, this blanket. I got this from CB2. And it's a, I think it was called the alpaca blanket. I can't remember what it's called, but it's pretty much like an alpaca blend type blanket. And the one thing I'll say about this blanket is it does shed a lot. So if you're somebody who's looking for a blanket to like relax with and like hang out with, this is probably not the blanket for you. But if you're looking for a blanket to like throw on the couch and style a different way just to make your home feel a little bit extra cozy, but it's not necessarily for a practical use, this is a great blanket because it's a really great price point, but and it looks really, really great. But I just personally don't love laying with it just because it sheds so much. But what I'm trying to say is layering your home with blankets and faux fur and just having all of that like extra coziness just like out during the holidays. I'm the type of person who doesn't like it out normally, but during the holidays I think it just feels extra inviting and extra cozy. All right, you guys, so that was it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, this little tour of my modern minimal holiday decor. If you did, I would love if you could like this video and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. I do lots, whoa. One of the logs just broke down a little bit. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, I will link as much as I can down below, but feel free to let me know if you have any questions. And I hope you guys are having an amazing holiday season. It's just so nice to be able to get together with your family and your friends and be able to celebrate just the reason for the season, right? I hope you guys are having a good one, and I will talk to you on my next video.